Like, Gretchen was never one to keep things on the rails. Remember?
I know, but this is the like the first game.
I don't know. Poisonous Zanzibar hamsters was pretty wild.
Yeah, those were silly, but this was, you know.
Oh, this is like batshit crazy.
Yeah.
Also, poisonous Zanzibar hamsters are from a whole different time. 8-bit home computers were just a whole different metagame. So that was Mantis.
I don't. What is. Alright, first off, what is a mental feedback loop? I never got that line.
But, like, try to imagine, like, suddenly you just hear this weird whining in your head.
So, yeah, an important part of the old SIGs run is that we're going to have to manually select cards every time we want to open a door. Hey, Johnny.
Oh.
You all right? You all right, buddy? You need a hand? You'll be fine.
I'm actually surprised that they were able to keep the sense of the mosaics.
Did anyone restock the emergency launch? Nope. We'll have to seek new pastures to continue the hunt.
You're going to have to move faster if you want to not die.
There's ammo. Good stuff.
Yeah. Anyways, back to a feedback loop. I'm thinking they were describing, like, did you ever just, like, have a time where you're just sitting there in a quiet area and you just hear this high-pitched whine in your head?
I think. Okay.
Yeah, imagine that, like...
Yep, torture rooms
that
right
just
kind of
doubles up high every other second. I think that's a feedback loop.
Yeah, we're not getting in there for a long time.
That's a code 6 door. What can you get there?
Not from this,
torture.
This is where we store the pain.
Tommy gun. Right,
they didn't have any of those here.
Am I the only one that sees those elevator lines as 131 and 132?
I'm gonna have to actually look at
sure
the doors
which,
to judge
which, lines
which ones
you're talking
I have
about.
Access to.
The elevator buttons.
Oh. I'll
have to see them again, but...
No, I, like, see, I see...
There's
the
C4.
V2.
Got a new one.
But you,
I see.
You didn't check for traps.
Who would trap a storeroom? That's ridiculous.
Who would put explosives in a room full of explosives?
That's just heinously unsafe.
This game all the time.
Oh, this is the door one.
Grenade.
You just gotta rub your ass on the door to open it.
Yeah.
All right. Where's the ones with all the trap doors in it?
That comes later.
Yeah. Additional bullets. Good. Oh really, Wall? Oh really? Watch me. Just watch me, Wall.
Did this game have the lockers?
Not yet.
Lockers came out in 2.
Okay. Yeah, because Kojima really had fun with lockers.
Yep.
And this is a door 4. Yeah, I think that's for when we have to come back for the sniper rifle later. Yeah, where is that? There's the hole in the wall.
Yeah, it took Kojima 3 games to just do in-game item cycling. God damn it.
Can't you look forward with a triangle or something like that?
Yep.
But you can't aim.
I just usually find it easier
to
stick
to
things, since all that requires is a movement arrow.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can aim in twin sticks, though, which breaks the game in a lot of ways.
Yep.
I think they would have changed up the Ocelot fight a bit.
Eh, they weren't thinking.
There we go.
I mean, it was the bright new age of 480p, all this new high-definition technology. More fidelity!
God, the GameCube was only 480p?
Yep.
Everything was before then. It's,
In fact, I think only PS2 was the only...
Standard definition TVs were still standard.
I think
standard.
The PS2 was the only, golden era system that could do 720, and that was late in the series. Actually, no, I think the really basic PS2 could do HD composite, but I just don't think TVs were, affordable back then.
Oh yeah, watch out.
Son of horse!
Turret gun.
Always beach staffing.
No, don't do that. That hurts.
Never outrun your grenades, folks!
Oh my god, Loon.
Good work.
Workplace safety, everybody!
I told you about the turret gun! I know it was too late for the first one, but...
it's like you're trying to protect someone there.
It's like nothing happened.
No, that's the wrong way, though.
Yeah, that's a side path.
It's totally unnecessary. Isn't this where you get the camera in one of the versions? I don't know which one.
Yeah, we'll find out in a moment.
I think you need
not to outrun our grenade.
I'm pretty sure you need a key card, though, that we don't have. I think you need to backtrack to this.
We'll find out shortly.
After we get tortured.
I don't know if you could kill Johnny and Twin Snakes, but I think the time paradox thing was only, like, fully comically realized in Snake Eater.
Four.
And six. And nothing else. Okay.
Yeah, we'll have to come back here.
Oh, the days when Chaff was considered a viable electronic
lunch,
device.
Lunch. Oh no. No!
360 no brunch. Lose all of it immediately. Perfect. Optimal.
Just shove the lunch in your holes.
Alright.
Take all the tater tots, stick them in the bullet holes.
Yeah, they actually render the entire room before you even have to enter it. You can just
I actually did,
Yeah, I already knew about, like, if you violence through this door, you will set off the explosives and get a custom game over.
What's custom game over? What? Do it! Like, I want to see this.
No.
Ow.
Get your own.
No, I set up enough on my own. I can't. Too much game over. Too late. All kinds of game over.
We got quotas to meet.
Also, nobody ever has any eyes in this game.
Nope. He's
alive. Everybody's just wearing cool guy shades.
Everybody's eyes are considered subpixels. I'm here to save it's texture.
I mean, I know it's a technological limitation, but it's still kind of like... It's cool and goofy in its own ways.
Oh, time for action. Well, eventually. Time to discuss, then we action.
Yeah, it seems like this that I think the Twin Snakes guys were like, this should be every game.
How long did you spend setting this up, Adam?
I was bored. Revolver Ocelot.
Ocelot.
I've been waiting for you, Solid Snake.
Is Patrick Lane still in the business?
Now we'll see if the only there were some way to find out. Some repository of all human knowledge.
I'm just too lazy to find. Wow, look at that texture clipping.
This is the best gun!
This gun is the best gun ever.
Yeah, we were kind of freaking out over all the art assets going on here. Now I'll show
you why they call. Was this... Did this happen in a PlayStation, or is this just emulation issues?
I think less so in a PlayStation.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so. Did you guys ever see the random name generator for Metal Gear Solid code names?
I think so. I don't really
remember what. I remember the one I got was Shotgun Elephant, and I could not stop laughing.
Shotgun is a pretty good name. One.
The visceral feeling of slamming long silver bullets in a chamber. I didn't realize this was the order.
All right. I need more bullets. Gotta find some that... Okay, there we go. Find a box of bullet that hasn't spawned dangerously close to the wire. Whoa, hold on. There's been a clear violation of our workplace safety code here. There we go.
Physics.
There we go. All is well.
I can't believe
you... We've reestablished our standard in practice. Yeah, we're empty. Did not notice. Feel of reloading in battle. Let me punch you, Adam.
If we made a revolver sniper, would Ocelot just lose his shit?
There we go. But to you, it'll be the smell of your own death. What does death smell like? Not a dead thing, but death itself.
I was gonna
the
say,
moment that life ends, what is the smell of that? That's the smell of rot you're thinking of, not death, not really death.
Might want to stick some lunch in your wounds.
Yeah, lunch is being applied, medicinal.
Rub pizza all over
I'm
your staff.
I'm definitely wasting a whole lot of ammo when I get into each attack.
Yeah, he only takes one bullet.
Gotta be sure, man.
what was it, rule number one? What was it, the third rule in Zombieland? Don't be stingy about your bullets.
Rule one is double tap.
Yeah, rule one. No, rule one is cardio. Rule two is cardio. I can't remember what rule is double tap.
Maybe three.
Fuck zombie apocalypse. They're very discriminative against smokers.
They were like, the cardio thing was just bashing a lot of people.
Asthmatics.
As a former asthmatic, I was somewhat like angry. But like the main scene that they showed to discuss cardio was a fat dude getting run down. It's terrible.
There we go, victory.
Yay.
Good. Just what I'd expect from the man with the same. Pretty good.
Can't kill him though. He's Kojima's he's Kojima's favorite character.
I'm glad they didn't.
Five games.
Didn't they jump through that wire just now?
I like the actor there, where for the moment that he's screaming about his arm, he doesn't have the growl on his voice. I like that. In particular because, perhaps coincidentally, perhaps retroactively, deliberately, it does sound kind of like the voice they give young Ocelot in 3.
Yeah. Huh.
So here's a little bit of a weird thing about my experience with Metal Gear Solid. I played 2 before 1, so all this cyborg ninja nonsense was completely lost on me until I played 1.
Yeah. Ah!
However, this shit was great!
I don't like what they did with the voice actors in the second one. I mean, the Twin Snakes.
Oh, yeah. It's, like, they tried to go... They put more into, like, trying to be a movie than just updating the features, and that kind of... That, like, really kind of hampered the game in certain ways. Like, remember when... In the scene where Sniper Wolf captures Snake in the PS1 one, he just goes, like, he just kind of goes along with it, but in Twin Snakes, he fights off, like, 4 dudes before getting, like, casually tapped in the back of the head and then, like, falling.
Yeah.
And then the famous door.
Just wave your old man stick at us while you say that. I resisted mind probes in my day, sonny! I fought my share of wizards, boy.
Oh no, the contradictions are piling up now.
Questions within questions. I'm sure. In that
case, how did they get more code? See, this is the kind of shit that goes over my head because I did not notice this when I was first playing through. Like I had instantly.
I did, but I didn't. I noticed them, but I didn't come to the conclusion that the DARPA chief was already dead.
Yeah, to me, I was like, oh, DARPA Chief had mental insulation. Whatever, I don't care about DARPA Chief. He's gone. You're a funny man. So the DARPA Chief, is he okay? So I could never fully appreciate a Metal Gear Solid because the writing and shit is beyond me. That's probably why I like Metal Gear Solid 3 the best, because it's the simplest one.
I guess so, yeah.
It's a Bond movie, that's all it is.
It's more complex than that.
You managed to fit so much characterization into just this old man hitting us with a stick.
Yeah, I know. I love that. Yeah.
Oh, doesn't he also... Those boys are totally
insane. They would in Twin Snakes, we end up pointing a gun at him at some point. But
what do they yeah.
Why?
Because frustration when he forgets the code or something.
Yeah.
I think it's over Meryl's frequency. Well, I'm not going to let these maniacs start a war today. You still have
the card keys. Card keys? To override the detonation code, I heard you had... Hmm, isn't this the... No, not anymore. Didn't they use the same, like, general model, like... I don't want to say trope, but, like, general look for the, American and Snake Eater? It must be.
She said she just joined up as a new... The American? You mean the Russian guy?
The dude that's... Yeah.
Sokolov.
Yeah, no, Sokolov is the...
Granin is the other one. The one who...
Yeah,
Granin. Okay, yeah.
We was like, Rocket's thing! No, stupid. Sure worthless. You have legs. Put legs on tank. He's good tank. Has legs now. Can walk. I was in contact with you by Kodak. And
until I slowed down extremely restricted speed.
Would play like a management sim game about competing mad scientists trying to get their projects funded.
What frequency was she at? Oh, dude, we should totally make a game company and do that.
You have to design a super weapon and secure funding and maintain strategic viability and fight off spies and so forth.
So basically, Evil Genius, but with Metal Gears.
Rocket-powered hovercraft. That's stupid.
It actually is when you think about it. Because the main thing that made what was it called?
Shagahead.
The one thing that made the Shagahead great was its ability to, like, just kind of get up and move around without the treads.
Yeah. Well, the only...
part hovercraft, part screw tread tank.
The only
with rockets on it. It's great.
The only reason it had such range was because it could accelerate so much, right?
Yeah,
it could actually accelerate to max speed and then fire.
It used the rockets on the chassis to serve as a reusable first stage.
Yeah, I think Sokolov's initial thing was like, this is going to be a multi-purpose tank that could also like jump on walls and... Or not jump on walls, climb
on mountains. Yeah,
this is an all-terrain vehicle that could be used to launch a missile.
But you need a runway to launch a missile.
Yeah.
And guess what Vulcan had?
It wasn't
perfect. Oh my god.
Yeah. It had bugs to work out, okay?
Oh, jeez. These like, scared me as a kid.
The weird stock footage cutscene segments.
I totally forgot about these.
When I was a kid, I played a lot of JRPGs, so I miss shit like this. Many of the drums
are corroded. With nuclear waste. Just, we don't give a shit about nuclear waste. We're kind of neglectful about that.
Yeah.
Did you guys ever watch the movie Sahara?
Pound after pound of muff.
I did not.
So much
muff. It's basically the same plot of this. This dude just dumped a lot of nuclear waste somewhere.
The black markets are just drowning in muff.
Scary.
Unemployment. Unemployment will end the world.
Well, it kind of is now. We live in an age when any small country can have a nuclear weapons program. What about the other superpowers? Russia and China still maintain a significant nuclear presence. You know, the dude does bring up a good point. Any small civilization can just, you know, make a nuke and become a threat. See Gandhi. Fucking Civ 5 every time. I have a nuke! Bend to my will. You mean Metal Gear. You know our industry suffered quite a blow as a result of the cuts in military budgets due to this so-called... Didn't we already have this cutscene before? I remember
hearing yes.
This is a different view of
They really
Metal
like
Gear.
To hammer home the views
Just keep panning over the Metal Gear.
We've seen this cutscene 6 times before. You know what's funny? One of my friends actually bought a model kit for a really huge scale Metal Gear, and he's too afraid to build it because he doesn't know how to paint. You can get a great lead time on your
weapons production, and no one can bother you. The bureaucracy snake! Aren't liberals on the military
oversight committee. Oh yeah, have you guys ever played Chromehounds?
Nope.
Ah, that was basically like imagine a slightly slower team-based armored core. But the cool thing about this is that you could like build your mechs in any way you want. And one of the metagames was to take like 7 sniper cannons, mount them in a wing formation, and put them on reverse legs, and basically all of them looked like Metal Gear. Except, you know, instead of one railgun, you have 7.
Oh boy, optical disc. That was a weird little island of technology.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that was like... Remember, didn't Sony try to like make that the next big music format? Not UMD. No, not UMD. It was before that.
No, the MD.
Oh.
Minidisc.
Yeah, that one.
It showed up in, one of them showed up in Parasite Eve 2, and I was like, what the fuck is that?
Want to know more? No, you go on without me. They got my password.
They don't want anything else from me. I have one more question. Who or what? I think the issue with the MD and the UMD is that it's really easy to fuck it up, because I remember... Like, 2 UMDs I had got messed up because one little tiny speck of something got into the disc, and then when I put it in a PSP, it would spin at high speed along with the debris, and it just ruined the disc.
Yep, that's Sony for you.
She knows better than I.
What is product testing? I don't know.
You've got to stop them. If it goes public, my company and I are...
You've got to stop them for my stock prices! My shareholder snake, you gotta do it for them!
Oh god, the beard overlay. There it is. I like how Fox Dye is depicted as a person furiously shaking their chest.
Oh no, he's got the jiggling!
Like, you'd think they'd grab their chest or something, but no, they're
he
just like...
He can't because his arms are broken.
Oh, right. Explosion.
Torture.
Did DARPA Chief do that?
A little bit. Then he tried to grab you, and then just kind of fell over.
Wait, if his arms is broken, how is he able to hit our legs?
One of his arms is broken, the other has his hitting stick.
Okay.
So,
are you listening? Now he's
I think what he's talking, what he was talking about, the nuke is the thing that has new technology, right?
Lots of drugs
that can cause a heart
attack in large doses. I don't think so. If I remember right, they just reactivated the nuke.
No, he said, well, Metal Gear itself uses currently existing technology, but...
Currently existing technology. I trust her more than
you can trust me. Yeah, we already established we don't know what the hell that means. There's
a lot of electrical interference. A lot of things existed way back in this day that didn't. Like neural implants to stop psychics. Probably impossible. Hell, I don't even think we have neural implants.
I can
for
think
anything.
Of a way that phrase makes sense if you rearrange it, that we didn't invent anything new for the purposes of this machine.
We just kind of. It's just basically creative.
There aren't any new discoveries that have gone into the creation of it. It's just like existing materials and.
People just realize, hey, this anti-personnel walking tank can be used to launch a nuke. Let's do this.
I remember now. It's the nuke doesn't use any propulsion. It's a stealth weapon.
Yeah, that's the eventual twist later on. Because it's a rail gun. It doesn't have a rocket trail that you can observe. Anyway, we're back in Flavor Country. A man is dead.
So yeah, it is no new technology. It's just a creative use of existing stuff, like rail guns in the 90s.
Yeah.
Can't believe
All right.
this.
So let's Meryl's phone number. That's somewhere on this dial. Who's gonna be my back of the box today?
Hang on. I have it right here.
I might have it.
Spin the codec wheel.
If you guys can hear me, 140.15.
Nope.
7-4-7.
What?
You sure it wasn't
1-4-1? Unless it's not available yet.
I don't think it's available yet. Because Colonel Campbell tells you it. He says look in the back of the box, so...
No, why would Colonel tell you?
He does. That was the big thing.
Baker's the one who forgets because he's dying.
Yeah, no, he says, call my niece, she's in the area, but I don't know her codec, check the back of the box.
Alright, let's head, yeah, event flags appear to be what's missing here. Floor one. Right then, and now there are guards.
I don't know why, but every single time...
Come traps.
I don't know why, but any time somebody discuss event flags in any game, I think of, I believe it was one of the Tony Hawk games that introduced me to this concept when they called it gaps in the stage. So I just think of gaps and I'm like,
No brother in here. We're not particularly understocked in anything. Let's just tap the button. Get on with our lives.
The Wheel of Codec. See, look at that. It says 131 and 132.
That's a B, High Wang.
I know, but I just see 13.
They're letters, High Wang.
No, they're clearly numbers. Yeah, if I remember right, Snake gets pissed off because the big door ain't opening, and then you have to call someone to get the big door open.
Meryl.
Somebody tells you to call Mara. Yeah.
Somebody's sleeping there. Yeah. The red dot.
Choke them.
The red dot that's very hard to see.
There is no choking mechanics yet.
Yes, there is.
Are there?
Yeah, you could totally
you
choke.
Have to be, you have to be not moving. You have to be behind somebody, and you have to press square.
Yeah, I distinctly remember getting pissed because I was trying to do a pacifist run for my first Metal Gear Solid 1 run.
Oh, there we go.
And then I snap a dude's neck.
Alright, never knew about neck stabbing existing in this game. Always just assumed you'd have to, you know, crawl quietly past...
How do you knock someone out like that, though?
That was neck snapping. I just I mashed the button instead of holding it, so...
Oh, right.
I wrangled him until he fell down.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is a door. Cannot touch at this time. I have only a level 2 skin of a jig.
Maybe we should call the colonel. Oh, and the tank is gone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Smoking? Guess who took it?
So what?
Didn't you know that cigarettes tank guy. Benzopyrene, a chemical that leads
to the lungs? We now know that when benzopyrene enters the scene. To benzopyrene
dioxide. Tell me about the chemistry of smoking.
Oh, don't ruin this for me.
You know Kojima saw. You know Kojima saw Devil May Cry 3 and was like, "Oh yeah, I got to get on this missile surfing business." You don't know how good a cigarette tastes in the morning.
By Campbell, I meant Campbell. I'd like to speak to Campbell. Hello.
Yes, I don't think you know what I meant when I...
What the hell are you doing? Wait,
I touch Campbell, I mean Campbell. Not Hunter.
Oh, we're not getting any tips, so what are we supposed to do here?
I'm not looking for Madame Chasseur there. I would like the Colonel. Merrill's holding, or find the Metal Gear chief engineer that President Baker mentioned. Let's find Hal Emmerich. In any
case, you should contact... Oh, yeah. Let's not. It's okay. Let's not start that whole thing.
The Colonel reminds you of that statement, but it's Baker who gives it to you in the first place.
Yeah.
That's why Snake points a gun at him in Twin Snakes, but he forgets the code.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello. Now we are allowed.
So I find it interesting that they are able to get away with the low-poly models with having no details by having these codec segments. That's pretty clever. You think you're some kind of one-man army? I don't need lectures. Like, when you need body language, you could just go into codex, and it's really easy. And saves up on resources, too.
Well, more when you need facial expressions. Body language can happen on the models, because they can gesture. Are you
Solid Snake? I remember somebody telling me that, like, most of communication is based on body and facial language. Like, internet discussion is only, like... roughly, like, what, 15% of actual dialogue? Then you have to deal with, like, vocal tone and expression, which is, like, the key facets of
rookie eyes.
And rookie eyes. They're beautiful, compassionate eyes. Oh, just what I'd expect from the legendary Solid Snake. Oh, shut up, Snake. Don't worry. You'll land back on them once you meet me. The reality is no match for the Hal Emmerich, that sounds like a nerd's name. I actually enjoyed Ocelot's characterization.
Ocelot. Because
you Ocelot and Hal.
Ocelcon!
Ocelcon!
Could you imagine?
The only Ocelot convention.
All Ocelots,
it's
all
the time. My favorite Ocelot convention!
Ocelot's the only person at the convention and he's enjoying the shit out of it because he funded it.
It's like something out of one of my cat videos. What are
you
doing?
You ever go on the internet, Snake? It has loads of cat videos. Let me show you some of my favorite cat videos.
I can't get off the line.
I was inspired to build robots because cats are fucking ridiculous. Look at these things. If they can figure out how to walk, anything can.
There you go. You gotta say that, but Japan actually has, like, a model that's a cat transforming into a Gundam. It's the most ridiculous thing. Right, for the development of Metal Gear. Colonel. Foxhound and the next generation special forces were called here for the test launching of a dummy nuclear warhead. It's funny, I have a bunch of my friends played like Worms Armageddon back when it was on last summer sale? And I came up with a team which is basically I just labeled it Metal Gear Solid, and the first character is 30-minute intro. Because this was to be a final test before the formal adoption of the Metal Gear program. Because of things like this.
Sounds kind of fishy. So what do you think the terrorists want?
Sorry, I'm not sure. I was captured with President Baker right after the revolt started.
Oh yeah.
Would love to compare the gameplay to dialogue ratio of this to Front Mission.
Amazing, you were able to get
30% to probably 60%. Anyway, you met Baker, huh?
How's he holding up? He's dead. People keep asking me about folks who just died.
The chief died from a heart attack too. Maybe I should be an undertaker. Was either of them
sick or anything? Is anyone? No, it just keeps happening in conversations. Just know how's Ben been? Dead. Something funny's going
on. I'm the bearer of bad news.
Hey, have you met Janine? She's dead. Yet. Do you know the person who designed Metal Gear? You mean Dr. Emmerich? Yes. Is he still alive? Probably. He should be in the research lab in the second floor basement of the nuclear warhead. Second floor basement.
Such a weird way of saying that. Yeah, that's where his lab is.
I think they're forcing him to work on the nuclear launching program. I can kind of see what they mean, but...
The more established English term is sub-basement for basements under basements. Multiple floors of basement.
It's the basement inside the basement, like Silent Hill. When you go into
the
hospital basement.
The inner basement.
And then you go into the basement underneath the basement, and then that's where the worst place is.
The basement of the second floor? The first floor? Maybe these buildings are built, like, a full building on top of each other. So you have the basement, and then a floor, and then the basement of the overbuilding, and then the second floor. And then another basement. No way. Just foundations stacked up to the heavens. I'm not green. Oh, yes, you are. You pause for just 1 second in front of your enemy and it's all over. Good luck doesn't last forever. I don't know what happened. I just couldn't pull the trigger right away. I never had any 1 second's hesitation in front of the enemy gets a kill. That happened twice while we were busting out of prison. I hesitated. Shooting at targets and shooting at living, breathing people are different. Let's talk about death. Ever since I was a little girl, I always dreamed about being a soldier. Yeah, I was going to declare an intermission after this dialogue was over, but it's going long enough that I could just walk away and come back later. Back in a second.
This is basically the gate popcorn scene. Allow myself to quit now. Listen, Meryl. Everybody feels sick the first time they kill someone. Unfortunately, killing is one of those things that gets easier the more you do it. In a war, all of mankind's worst emotions, worst traits come out. It's easy to forget what a sin is in the middle of a battlefield. But this isn't a war. It's a terrorist action. You're just a little jumpy from the combat high. The adrenaline in your bloodstream is starting to thin out. Just take it easy. But I learned all about combat high at the academy. We'll talk about it later. For now, just think about keeping yourself alive. If I get out of here alive, I'll think about that other stuff. Okay. Let me try to say this another way. Stay the hell out of my way. You're a real bastard. Just like my uncle said. Huh. I told you. The real me is no match for the legend. It looks like you were right. Okay, Snake. I'll be a good girl. We'll link up after I grab the doctor. Then we'll take care of the detonation code override. Gotcha. But listen, I know this area better than you. Call me if you have any questions. Be careful, okay? After I open up the cargo door, I'll contact you.
War is hell, huh? Alright, good. I managed to shake them off. Let's carry on. With the gear.
I managed to shake off the cutscenes. Let's call someone else.
Alright, this is a whole other install from the last time I played this game, so, yeah, there aren't any residual saves for Metal Gear. The graveyards are full
of indispensable men. Tankgrenade.gif is 4 megabytes. Well. You're right.
Wow. You know all sorts of great all quotes. Kinds of quotes!
Isn't this game, like, designed to where if you ever get into a straight gunfight, you're gonna lose because you're always outnumbered?
sometimes.
Like, I don't ever think there's been a fair fight aside from fighting Liquid Snake atop the Metal Gear.
You usually need to find some sort of shenanigans method to work to your advantage.
Yes.
I kind of want to go upstairs and see if there's any loot to retrieve. Because I think there's some loot to retrieve, at least a little bit. Yes, stun grenade is the great equalizer.
Stun grenade. Even works on cameras.
Yes! Box A! The only reason that we will ever leave Cigarette for more than a few seconds at a time is Box A.
Was there ever a game where you could smoke inside the box?
No idea.
Unfortunate.
And there's another locked room over here, I believe, that we can collect some sort of loot from. First, we have to deal with this man.
Oh, is that Twin Snakes? It is.
What now?
Snake,
oh, Mel.
I unlocked the car.
Okay, door's open. Good.
I have a huge issue with the cutscene imagination list listed mainly because the grenade gets unpinned and then stays longer, then doesn't explode for more than 3 seconds.
Yep, like accidentally overrode the dialogue on that one. I thought it was shorter than it would be. It's always a bad decision when you're trying to judge the length of Metal Gear scenes. Alright, I should use my suppressor on my gun. Also, my card to open this door.
Cigarettes can't open a door. What are you doing, Snake?
Well, that ended poorly.
Who would have thought the legendary Solid Snake would be killed by our simple Russian?
Oh, no, wait, these are American. The U.S.
Yeah,
Special
Russians
Force.
Are too. I keep forgetting.
Important national security mission.
Yes, I am an American soldier protecting motherland country. Oh yeah, they don't have a nationality because they are they're bio soldiers.
They still have citizenship, Wang. You don't. It's not aristocratic bloodlines, it's national affiliation.
Says you. The genome soldiers are the new monarchy, and they're bringing that shit home. Ah, damn it.
Right, card, indoor. Out of gun. Must switch to Punch Man. And under desk. No, that won't work. Not like this alone. And I'm out of lunch. Must play very carefully with that in mind. One of the sides of this desk can be crawled under. Yes, there we go. Now we are invisible.
Because genome soldiers, in all their brilliance and...
In enhancing all of their other soldierly properties, they lost the ability to bend their knees.
Yeah. Or bend their neck. I think chat is right in saying that, yeah. Weren't the genome soldiers based on Big Boss's genetic code?
Yes.
When we are all the Big Boss, nobody is the Big Boss. Almost makes you think.
Almost. Just for a minute.
All right, not really.
Let's prepare the chaff.
The chaff is just a cloud that persists around you.
Yep. Anyway.
Hasn't chaff recently been disproven that it doesn't do any of this shit?
Like, what?
And by recently, I mean like 5 years ago.
Like, how do you mean?
Like, it doesn't jam anything at all.
Well, it...
I mean, not jam. Like, it doesn't interfere with radar or radio waves.
It depends on the materials involved. Alright, we've made it through that whole ordeal. The upper floor. Did we
too bad
up...
you're gonna smoke yourself to death.
Did we end up resetting that event flag of talking to Meryl already?
Who are you?
I was really impressed with the way you busted.
Yes,
yourself out
this
there.
Whole dialogue has to happen again. So,
fast forward. Go get another beer.
Your uncle.
I too have an uncle.
Let's discuss uncles together. President Baker. Heart attack. Dr. Emmerich. Green. Bastards. Ha 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 ha. Did not mean to call again.
Don't be so impatient.
Alright. Now we need to find biscuits.
Biscuits?
Some kind of edible is called for.
Oh.
I want this man to fall asleep. Any day now, buddy.
This wall is really interesting.
I just love walls. What does it look like to be this?
This is a masterwork crafted wall. At this rate, you are gonna smoke yourself to death.
Pretty sure you can't die of smoke damage. Pretty sure.
Well, I guess you're right, because you should have died. Quite a while ago, if that were the case.
Thanks. Where are you?
Well, I can see ya.
Don't move around too much.
Don't worry, I'm disguised in this enemy uniform.
You won't be for long with the way you walk.
What does that mean?
You have a rookie's ass.
Listen, Snake, the cargo door is like an airlock.
That's such a weird thing to look back on. Familiar ass was the most... was a gameplay element.
Okay. So we'll meet at the nuclear warhead storage building.
Wait.
You have so much sass that it will just give away your identity.
My mind.
Don't get careless.
Booty wiggle is what's gonna give you away.
Sorry, but this is the only
critical
way
overload
out
of attitude.
I cut out to be a soldier. I gotta get my hands dirty.
These guys,
I have to kill a man.
You're gonna get yourself killed.
See you there.
I must taste blood, Snake.
Then, only then, can I become a squad leader in 4?
Are you gonna sleep or not?
I think your bloodlust is keeping him awake.
You mind? Vaguely believed that you could affix the suppressor to the... Or is the suppressor in here?
The suppressor is on the left side. You have to use it in conjunction with your pistol.
Well, I mean, the object. I don't have the suppressor in my inventory now. Is it...
Oh.
Maybe it already joined with the pistol while I wasn't paying attention?
No. It would have a visible notification. Like, you would see the suppressor on the gun. which you don't.
That box might be the suppressor I'm looking for. Yeah, that's my suppressor. Do you mind? I'm here to pick up a suppressor.
You might have to attack aggressively. This man is way too interested in this shelving unit of...
Yep.
What looks like soup containers?
Perfect crime!